Hi, my name is Gloria Robert. Today we are discussing the topic Asexual Reproduction. Objectives of lesson. As the lesson progresses, the learners should be able to 1. Define reproduction, 2. Mention the two types of reproduction, 3. List and highlight the types of asexual reproduction, 4. Define vegetative propagation, 5. Mention the types of vegetative propagation, and 6. Give examples of each type. So what is reproduction? Reproduction is the ability of organisms to produce or give rise to offsprings of their own kind. Now, offsprings of their own kind means offsprings of the same species with the parent organism. For example, mango plants will produce mango plants, man will reproduce man, dog will reproduce dog. They are organisms of the same species. Now, as student, it is wrong for you to define reproduction as the ability of organisms to give birth to their young ones or offsprings of their own kind. Now, why is this so? Remember that reproduction is one of the characteristics of living things. Plants and animals are the only living things we have on earth. Now, it is clear that plants can never give birth to their young ones. Also, animals such as fishes, reptiles, amphibians, even birds, they can't give birth to their young ones. They lay eggs. These eggs hatch into young ones. So it is wrong to generalize reproduction as the ability of organisms to give birth. So the best way to define reproduction is to say reproduction is the ability of organisms to produce or give rise to offsprings of their own kind or of the same species. Now, there are two types of reproduction. The first one is called asexual reproduction, and the second is called sexual reproduction. Now, asexual reproduction, this is the type of reproduction which involves only one parent in order to produce an offspring. Now, here there is no need for the male organism, the female organism is not needed. Just one parent when we can have several offsprings. Now, in asexual reproduction, no sex gametes are involved. So they are not like sperm cell, egg cell, no need for that, alright? No sex gametes are involved. So there is also no fission of nuclei or gametes. Rather, the cells that give rise to the offspring usually divide by means of mitosis or mitotic cell division. Simply put, no fertilization in asexual reproduction. Now, the last point here is that new organism formed is usually the same as the parent organism. That means the new organism or offspring is the exact copy of the parent organism. You can say that the new organism is the clone of the parent organism. Why is this so? Because there is no genetic variation between them. All right, types of asexual reproduction. The first one we are looking at is binary fission. The word binary means two. The word fission means break. So simply put, it means the breaking of an organism into two. Good. Now, this is the simplest form of asexual reproduction, and it occurs in unicellular organisms such as in bacteria and protists. Now, examples of protists are amoeba, euglena, paramecium, chlamydominous, and so on. Alright? Now, in this type of asexual reproduction, the parent organism divides into two parts when they become fully matured, and each of the individual formed can exist by themselves. Now, here we have images of binary fission in amoeba, binary fission in euglena, and binary fission in paramecium. Now, you can see the matured amoeba parent dividing, and at the end, two daughter cells are formed. This also takes place in euglena and the paramecium. Now, the good thing is that these new daughter cells can exist all by themselves. Now, the second we are looking at is budding. Now, in budding, the parent organism develops an outgrowth known as bud. Now, if you study the image here, you can see what the bud looks like. Now, this one will subsequently forms the new individual organism. Okay. Now, one good thing about budding is that this bud can break off from the parent organism without causing any injury of any kind to them. And so they can even live independent on their own. They can fall or be planted, and then they can live on their own. All right, it can also take place in organisms such as hydra Alright, now the next one we are looking at is pod formation. This is also known as sporulation. Now in this kind of asexual reproduction, the parent organism produces spores. Now spores are small, light unicellular bodies which are easily dispersed or spread by air or wind. Okay, now examples of organisms that can carry out this kind of reproduction, we have mushroom, we have mucor, we have rhizopods, toastu. They are all fungi. So fungi are organisms that can carry out sporulation. Now here we have image of a rhizopod. Now the spores are found in that structure called sporangium. Okay, now this can burst open to release the spores. The spores are then carried by wind, or should I say air. Okay, now when they fall on suitable surface such as on a leaf, on a wood, even on the soil, they can grow into new offsprings. The next one we are looking at is fragmentation. Now in fragmentation, a part of the parent organism breaks up to give rise to new organism. Now this type of reproduction is also called regeneration. Now it usually occurs in cnidarians such as in hydra, polyps and the rest. It can also take place in spirogyra, starfish, planaria and so on. Now here are images showing fragmentation in spirogyra, fragmentation in starfish, fragmentation in hydra. You can see a part of their body breaking off and then this later develop into new offsprings. Now the last one we are looking at is vegetative propagation. So vegetative propagation is also one of the types of asexual reproduction. It occurs in higher plants, that is flowering plants. Now in this process, a new plant grows from any portion of a plant other than the seed. Now what this means is that normally if you want to plant, let's say, a maize plant or mango plant, all you need to do is to get the seed of mango. This is planted covered with soil before you know it starts germinating. But in vegetative propagation, you don't need seeds. You can use any other part known as the vegetative parts, such as the roots, the stem, and even the leaves. Alright, for this reproduction. Okay, now let's look at types of vegetative propagation. The first one is natural vegetative propagation. Now, in this kind of vegetative propagation, it can involve one, use of modified underground stem. On the ground stem, we can have rhizomes such as in ginger, we can have bulbs such as onion, we can have comb such as in cocoyam. All these are on the ground stem that can be planted in order to get new offsprings. Now the second type or the second way you can carry out natural vegetative propagation is by the use of fleshy leaves. Example of this is found in bryophyllum. Bryophyllum plant, for you to reproduce it, you get the leaves, you put it in the soil, cover it up. In few weeks time, you see roots growing from the leaves. This germinates to form a whole or a full bryophyllum plant. Now the second type of vegetative propagation is artificial vegetative propagation. This method involves growing plants from cut portion of a plant artificially, that is by man's intelligence. Now these include the following. A. Layering. Now in this method, it involves cutting off the tip of a node on a branch of a plant, which is usually close to the soil, bending it to the soil, pegging it to the soil and covering it up with soil. Now what this means, if you study the image here, is that a branch that is very close to the soil is selected and this is bent down in such a way that the node on the plant is fixed into the soil. This is pegged down and after a while the part of the node begin to develop roots so it can be cut off or supported in order to germinate or to have a new offspring. Now when the node develops its root, like I said, it can be cut off and then transplanted. Now tomatoes, coffee and cocoa can be cultivated by this method. The second one here is cutting method. This involves the cutting of a long stem of a plant into smaller sizes. Now each of the small size must have two or more nodes on them. Okay, now if you look at the image here, we have the A here, we have a long stem that has been cut into smaller sizes. Don't forget that each of the small sizes must have two or more nodes on them. Now this is then planted into the soil, and after some time new offsprings are formed. So one long stem can give like 5 or 6 new offsprings. Okay, now these are then inserted into the soil for them to grow. So cassava, cocoa, sweet potato, hibiscus and even kola can be propagated by cutting method. The next one we are looking at is grafting. Now grafting is actually divided into two different type. We have the stem grafting and we have the bud grafting. So let's look at them one after the other. Stem grafting. This is the attaching of a shoot of one plant, which is called the scion, on the shoot of another plant, which is known as the stalk. Now don't forget that these two different plants must be closely related. Now they are tied together. These infuse together over time to become one plant. So all citrus plants such as lemon, oranges, tangerine and so on can be grafted by this method. If you study the image here, you see we have two different plants. The first one is the scion, that is the upper part of a shoot of a plant A, and then the lower part of a plant B, which is now forming the stalk. So the scion is attached to the stalk, tied together, is grafted together, and over time they become a single plant. Now the second type is bud grafting, which can also be called budding. Now this method involves cutting a bud from one plant, that is our plant A now, then attaching or inserting by tying it to another plant B with an inverted T-shape cut on it back. Now the bud is the scion and the other is called the stalk. The new plant that grows on the stalk is carefully removed after some week and transplanted. Now let's study this image to help us understand better. Now we have two different plants, plant A and plant B. They are closely related. Now the bud from the body of plant A is removed. Now on plant B, an incision, that means a cut, is made on the back or on the body, a T-shaped incision. Now you see that the bud from A is then attached to the incision of B and then tied together. After a while, you see the bud growing. So they fuse together as if they are now one organism. All right. Now, cocoa, rubber, and orange can be planted by budding. Okay. This is actually to help farmers to get desired characteristics or traits in plant. For example, if we have a plant with sweet, or should I say delicious, fruit, we have another one with big fruit, and a farmer wants a tree that can produce both at the same time, they can do grafting. So bring one plant with delicious fruit, bring another plant with big fruit, graft them together. At the end, you have a single plant that can have both characteristics, that is a delicious fruit and a large fruit all at once. Okay, let's move to the last one, and that is marcotting. In this type of vegetative propagation, a ring of tissue is cut from a branch to expose its phloem. So if you study the first image here, that is what is being done. The body of the branch of a tree is cut off in order to expose the phloem. The phloem is the part that translocates, or should I say move food from the leaves to other parts of a plant, and this is then covered with coconut husk with moist soil in it. So a coconut husk is gotten filled with moist soil and then tied around the exposed part of the branch. Now this is not tied to the branch. Okay, they are tied together till new roots begin to grow at that point that is exposed. New roots begin to grow, then the branch is later cut off and then replanted. So mango, lemon can be cultivated by this method. Wow, now it's time for our student activities. All you need to do is go through the question, answer the question. If you have challenge answering any one of them, no problem, go back to the video, listen to the video as many times as you can, and at the end I want to believe you'll be able to handle the question. So take your time and go through the questions. Wow, this is the answer to student activity. Now it's time for you to mark yourself. Like I will always say, I hope you have 100%. Now, question to number 10. It says, check video on sexual reproduction. So go to sexual reproduction and answer that question. Of course, you have to watch the video first. So at this time, I want to say thank you for joining me in this class. Thanks for learning.